Breaking news. Everybody's got COVID and we've got one new name to add to the list. Kayleigh McEnany apparently has coronavirus. She tweeted this after testing negative consistently, including every day since Thursday. I tested positive for COVID-19 on Monday morning while experiencing no symptoms. No reporters, producers, or members of the press are listed as close contacts by the White House medical unit. Moreover, I definitively had no knowledge of Hope Hicks' diagnosis prior to holding a White House press conference or press briefing on Thursday. We're gonna return to that. As an essential worker, I have worked diligently to provide needed information to the American people at this time. Okay, hold on. So first of all, and she's gonna quarantine. So first of all, you've never tried to do that. You weren't hired to do that. And there's a lot of essential workers in America, and people like you haven't cared whether they live or die for more than 6 months now. I got news for you. You ain't essential. You ain't essential for literally anything. It's a farce. It's really a mockery of democracy, which is interesting. It's intriguing, maybe, but it's not essential.
So is she gonna use this? Yeah, I mean, that all just reeks of like, how can more Trump officials steal bailout money from the American people? Kayleigh's calling herself essential. Is Mnuchin gonna cut her a check? Like, is that what happens? Because that's pretty much what happened in the last bailout.
I don't know.
Yeah. Kayleigh's got it.
Oh my God.
Kayleigh's got corona. She coughed all over the podium. All right. Here's the thing. I want to see Kayleigh on a Zoom call lying for the president from bed. Just like the Kung Flu. it's made up. Like the president. I don't know what she sounds like. I can't do it. Okay, let's do the let's do this. It's Kayleigh, but she's got a little cold. The president absolutely condemns white the proud.
Jesus, you're crazy. Okay, so look, I don't wish COVID on my second worst enemy. And she's not even that. So but I will say she kept doing the maskless things, and she says there that I totally didn't know, I didn't have it, I didn't expose a bunch of people. We'll see. How much can we trust her? I mean, have you been paying attention the past few months? And I will also say this, this is a video I was gonna play before I even knew this breaking news. Here she is being asked about Donald Trump's diagnosis, the timeline for that. And I want you to see how evasive and slippery she was able to be.
Hey there.
Hi, how are you?
Hello,
how are you? What's up, Mark?
Alyssa mentioned that the West Wing is planning to put out the number of staffers affected with COVID. She said you guys have the number. Do you know what the number is?
No, there are privacy concerns we take very seriously, safeguarding the information of the personnel here in the White House. So that's basically where we stand right now.
Did the president, we're told he's tested often. Was he tested on Tuesday before he went to the debate? And then was he tested on Thursday morning before he went to New Jersey?
Yeah, I'm not going to give you a detailed readout with timestamps of every time the president's tested. He's tested regularly, and the first positive test he received was after his return from Bedminster.
Was he tested between Wednesday night and the time he went to New Jersey?
Again, not giving a detailed readout of his testing, but safe to say his first positive test was upon return, or at least after Bedminster, that trip. Thank you guys very much.
Okay, so again, if he didn't do anything wrong and you're not hiding anything, why are you doing everything you can to make us wonder if you're hiding something? Because that was so evasive and the disingenuous. I'm not gonna give you like a detailed readout with timestamps. No, we're not asking for documentation. I don't want a spreadsheet. I'm not even interested in Excel. I asked if he was tested before the debate and you don't wanna answer that. You're saying you didn't do anything wrong, but you really don't wanna go on record about it. Why? Why be so evasive if he didn't do anything wrong? Why be so condescending towards that reporter that you might have been infecting with coronavirus right as we're watching that video? Francesca, I just can't take, you know, again, don't wish it on anybody except my actual worst enemy. But the dishonesty, the lies, the never ending lies, man.
I don't know why she stops. I mean, there's part of me that's like, okay, we're not that far down authoritarianism for her to not have to talk to the press and to ban the press, although they've been banned before from the White House. But why even stop? If you're just going to evade and kind of throw shade and be disrespectful about that and just kind of snippy, like Well, just keep your COVID to yourself, hon. And you know, keep your mask on, keep walking. You have nothing to say. The only thing I can come to is like, she feels important. Like, oh yeah, now I can answer. Now I can give a non-answer. Yay. Mm-hmm.
Maybe.
Yeah, it matters. I just want to say it matters when he tested positive. It absolutely matters. And it matters that, I mean, this is the thing with these debates. It's like, you assume, I mean, I feel like the NBA is taking more precautions than they are, right? Why can't we lock them all in a Disneyland complex and, you know, I don't know, do what they're doing? But like, really though, why was there a debate if they couldn't guarantee testing and a negative test before you are actually set to debate? And I will say one other thing is that apparently the White House and all the Trump administration has been misusing the Abbott test, which is like the rapid test for, which actually has like a 1 in 3 failure rate, a false negative rate. And they've been using it nonstop. Now, obviously I don't imagine they're doing it that much, but at least around the Rose Garden stuff and the announcement that couldn't wait of Amy Coney Barrett being their Supreme Court justice nominee to overturn ACA and Roe v. Wade, right? That that couldn't wait. And they've been misusing them. And so again, this is what happens when you don't believe in science and or you're too stupid enough to follow it.
Yeah, 100%.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.